Hello everybody, how are you? Well, today we are going to study the present perfect continuous. This is a class for fourth year secondary school. Present perfect continuous. We have already studied the present perfect simple. Now we are going to study the present perfect continuous. Before dealing with the structure, I am going to talk about the different uses of the present perfect continuous. Number one, to emphasize the duration of an action, not the result. Es decir, nos vamos a concentrar en la duración de la acción, no en el resultado. To show the cause-effect relation of an action with clear result in the present. Es decir, la causa-efecto, pero que vamos a ver el resultado evidente en el presente. And to talk about something that has been in progress recently or lately. Algo que haya estado pasando recientemente. Let's see. These are the examples of the different uses. Use number one. To emphasize the duration of an action, not the result. I have been planning classes for 3 hours. So I want to emphasize that I have been working for 3 hours. No estoy diciendo cuántas clases planifiqué, pero sí el tiempo que me llevó. I have been planning classes for 3 years. Notice, have been planning, ing. The streets are wet. Esta palabrita wet significa húmedo, mojado. The streets are wet. Why? It has been raining all night long. Es decir, es el uso 2. Muestro la causa-efecto. ¿Por qué están mojadas? It has been raining all night long. Has been raining, ing. Or, I can smell, smell es oler, I can smell cigarette smoke here. Have you been smoking recently? So, to talk about something that has been in progress recently. Have you been smoking recently? Es la pregunta. Fíjense de nuevo, tenemos have been smoking with ing. So, lo voy a correr un poquito, perdón, para buscar el marcador. So, as to write with the structure of this verb. So, we have the subject. I, street. Después del sujeto, ¿qué ponemos? Fíjense, acá pusimos have. Acá pusimos has. So, the subject plus have or has. Después, ¿qué ponen? ¿Qué ponen después del have o el has? Bien. Been, ok. And then we've got planning, raining, smoking. ¿Cómo se llaman estas terminaciones ing? En español gerundio, en inglés the gerund. That is to say the ing. En forma criolla le dirán los verbos con ing. En realidad no es un verbo, es un verboide, pero bueno, si lo entienden así, el verbo con ing, que se llama gerundio. Subject plus have, has, been, and the gerund. Podemos poner for on since, ¿sí? Como en este caso pusimos también en algunas oraciones. For example, I have been studying in secondary school for 4 years. You are emphasizing the duration. Hace 4 años que vienen estudiando en el secundario. I have been studying in secondary school for 4 years. Have been studying. ¿Qué es lo que no va a faltar en el presente perfecto continuo? El been, ¿ok? Después de have o has been. Recuerden que have is used with I, you, we, they. And has with he, she, it. Este es el presente perfecto continuo. Y sirve para esto. The activities. Estas son las actividades que ustedes van a tener que hacer en Edmodo. The first one is sentence transformation. Es decir, vamos a trabajar con transformación de oraciones. Yo les voy a dar una oración y ustedes tienen que parafrasear, transformar esa oración con el presente perfecto continuo. For example, it is raining. It started to rain last week. Fíjense, está lloviendo. Comenzó a llover la semana pasada. Entonces, en el presente perfecto continuo, yo quiero usar hacer el primer uso. dar énfasis a que hace una semana que viene lloviendo. So, it has been raining for a week. It has been raining since last week. Podemos utilizar for o since como ustedes quieran. Pero acá estamos dando énfasis a la duración de la acción. It has been raining for a week. It has been raining since last week. Sorry. Oh, the children are playing football. That is, yes, what is happening now. The children are playing football. And they started to play 3 hours ago. ¿Hace cuánto que están jugando? Hace 3 horas. So we have the action, play, and the time, the length. Es decir, la duración de la acción. Entonces, presente perfecto continuo. They, ¿por qué they? The children. They have, ¿por qué have y no has? Porque el sujeto es they. They have been playing football for 3 hours. So, giving emphasis to the duration of the action. They have been playing football for 3 hours. Remember, been. Okay? Been. 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 Don't forget that in the present perfect continuous, after have or has, you have to use been. And then the verb with ing, the gerund. Okay? Concentrate on this activity. Van a recibir oraciones y después ustedes la tienen que transformar usando el presente perfecto continuo con for or since. Okay? Well, that is all. Thank you.